Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon. I'm going to talk about Twitter. I'm going to talk about Space Daddy Elon Musk, and I'm going to talk about how he is whacking the beehive almost every day, making people very, very angry about Twitter, which is becoming definitely a pay-to-play proposition. Now Elon Musk is saying that only paid subscribers are going to show up in your Twitter For You feed. He's basically pushing everybody to subscribe to Twitter Blue, which is what, $7 or $8 a month now, $11 a month. Now, just the other day, he announced that they were going to retire the old blue checks, the verified check marks, and a lot of celebrities kind of lost their shit. Now, the people that are complaining about it, a lot of them are people that said they were going to leave Twitter anyway if Elon Musk bought it, and somehow they're still on the platform. They did not leave, and now they're angry they're losing their blue checks. Now there are articles being written about how blue checks never really mattered anyway by people that probably fiercely defended their blue checks because, you know, they were special. Now they're not. Nobody's special on Elon Musk's Twitter, except for some people. We're going to talk about this too, that apparently there's a secret VIP list that AOC, LeBron James, and Ben Shapiro get the VIP treatment from Twitter, that their tweets get more engagement. So we'll talk about all this and Elon Musk, you know, kind of denying. He said, I forgot to mention that accounts you follow directly will also be in For You since you have explicitly asked for them. So again, a lot of people going to For You to find new accounts to follow. But yeah, if they're not blue checks, oh well, Twitter is pay to play now, guys. So we're going to talk about this. Before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants. Almost 300,000 subs. I think after 300,000, I'm going to stop asking because it is kind of annoying. I admit it is kind of annoying. And it doesn't age very well. You know, when you go back and be like, oh my God, there they are begging for 75,000 subs. What's the deal? Anyway, I don't use Twitter much. I didn't quit the platform completely, but I did put a post up on clownfishtv.com that I'm not going to be using Twitter as much as I was before. And I'm not saying I'm not going to use Twitter at all. What I'm saying is I'm not going to be on there every day tweeting every damn thing that pops in my head because it is a waste of time. Twitter, in my opinion, is designed to waste your time. Now, people are kind of eulogizing it and talking about how it was, you know, it was the place where all the great thinkers of the world would congregate with our brilliant free blue checks. But now that Elon Musk took it over, it's an awful, dirty, dirty place. And only the alt-right are going to stay on Elon Musk's pay-to-play Twitter. Are they? These people can't figure out how to use Mastodon, and most of them can't run their own websites. So I have no idea what they're going to do, but I've pulled back. You know, the reality for me is, one, it was a complete, you know, waste of my time day to day. I was tracking my time. I'm like, I am spending way too much time on this platform, and I'm getting unnecessarily angry at people that don't actually exist because everybody's got like a Twitter persona. And I'm like, these are people that don't actually exist, could not actually exist in the real world. There's no way that this person can actually function in the real world. And I'm like, I'm not even going to tempt fate. Like, I'll pop in every once in a while, but I don't really want to use it day to day. I kind of started using it more when Musk took over because I thought it was going to fundamentally change. And so far, the only thing that has changed about Twitter is that the craziness has increased. And so has the price. So it was like, I was hoping that it would be a cleansing fire, but really it's chasing people off for all the wrong reasons in my personal opinion here. But here we go. This is what was announced earlier this morning. Elon Musk, only paid subscribers will show up in your Twitter For You feed. Elon Musk has announced that Twitter's latest push to get people to pay $84 a year for the social network Twitter will only promote paid subscribers' tweets, and non-subscribers will not be allowed to vote in polls. I mean, personally, I think that's kind of worth it because, you know, if you're paying, you should get extra features. I'm just like, a lot of what you're paying for now are features that were free for the longest time. I actually expected Twitter to be a little, Twitter Blue to be a little extra. You know, there's supposed to be some way to monetize your content on Twitter. I'm not seeing that. Things are breaking left and right. The crazy people are still on there. They didn't leave, and they're not being moderated very well either. You know, so whatever, whatever. Anyway, Twitter's For You tab, the first screen that users see when they open the app, curates tweets by using an algorithm. That means it can surface tweets from people you didn't follow. The For You tab will soon only recommend people who pay for the premium Twitter Blue service. And also, I forgot to mention, people you follow directly. But they're already For You because you're following them. Starting April 15th, only verified accounts will be eligible in the For You recommendations, he announced in a tweet Monday evening. It's the only realistic way to address advanced AI bot swarms taking over. It's otherwise a hopeless losing battle. Voting and polls will require verification for the same reason. Now, I do think that, you know, one of the advantages of being verified Twitter Blue is that you actually have or have a pretty good idea that you're dealing with a real person. I mean, very few people are going to pay for Twitter Blue accounts for like 10,000 bots, right? Appearing in the For You feed helps users build their number of followers. Voting in polls doesn't benefit users in the same way, but blocking them from voting may prompt some to sign up for the paid service. Depends on how addicted to Twitter you guys actually are. Musk frequently posts his own polls on Twitter, asking users everything from whether he should give up his position as CEO of the platform and whether he should sell shares of Tesla. Although Musk said Twitter is making the change to battle with bot accounts, he later tweeted that said it's okay to have verified bot accounts if they follow terms of service and don't impersonate a human. It's part of Musk's plan to shift Twitter away from being almost completely dependent on advertising for its revenue. So this is important. This is every website right now. It's not just Twitter. I mean, yeah, it kind of sucks. I get that. But like every website right now is trying to get people to subscribe directly to the website. They're trying to get you to subscribe for paywalled content. And the reason they're doing that is the advertising revenue is dropping off a cliff. Now they've tried, the media has tried to single out Elon Musk and say that his revenue is dropping and it's because he's Elon Musk. And the reality is the ad spends across the board are down. So I will give him that. Ad spends across the board are way down. It's not just Twitter. It's also Facebook. It's also Google, YouTube. Everybody is losing money right now. Even mom and pop websites. Our website has lost a substantial amount of money over the last year because people are just not spending money on advertising anymore. Weirdly enough, those sponsorship dollars are still flowing pretty freely, but I don't know. I don't know how long that's going to last either. Last week, Musk announced that users who had the free blue checkmark, typically government officials, celebrities, members of the media, and other high-profile users, would lose their free verification. And William Shatner was very salty about this, and so is Dan Slott. I'm going to pull that up too. Weirdly enough, Dan Slott does not have me blocked. I don't think I've ever attacked Dan Slott personally. I always thought it was weird he had me blocked. But I realized I'm not blocked anymore, so I don't know what's going on. For those of you who don't even know who Dan Slott is or who don't care, he's a comic book writer. He wrote Spider-Man for a number of years, and he's gotten a reputation for blocking people often on Twitter, even people that had nothing to do with, you know, any pushback or whatever because you follow the wrong accounts. That's my understanding. Maybe I'm not blocked anymore because maybe with the API changes to Twitter, the blockchains don't work anymore. That's possible. It could really be that simple. This is Shatner. Hey, Elon Musk, what's this about blue checks going away unless we pay Twitter? I've been here for 15 years giving my time and witty thoughts all for bupkis. Now you're telling me I have to pay for something you gave me for free? Musk responded to Shatner on Sunday. It's more about treating everyone equally. There shouldn't be a different standard for celebrities. Except when there is. So the New York Post and Engadget also put this up too. They said that Twitter's secret VIP list is the reason you see Elon Musk's tweets so often. Well, he paid $44 billion for it. I mean, he should just park himself at the top of everybody's For You page, right? There are a few dozen users that get an extra boost from Twitter's algorithm, according to a new report. There is a secret VIP list of a few dozen accounts it monitors and offers increased visibility to in its recommendation algorithm. The accounts include Elon Musk as well as a handful of other prominent Twitter users. So according to Platformer, the VIP list was originally created to monitor the engagement received by Twitter power users as the company has tried to allay suspicions that it shadow banned certain users to reduce their visibility. Our algorithm is overly complex, not fully understood internally. Musk said in a tweet. The list, which reportedly is only 35 accounts in addition to Musk, is also telling about who Musk believes should benefit from Twitter's algorithm. Platformer didn't publish the entire list, which includes LeBron James, AOC, venture capitalist Mark Andreessen, a Tesla fan account, I did know that, Tesla owners SV, and conservative personality Ben Shapiro. It also includes CatTurd2, an account recently described by Rolling Stone as the shitposting king of MAGA Twitter. It's also not the first time that a report has surfaced about how Musk has tweaked Twitter's algorithm to boost his own tweets. Last month, Musk said the company was fixing an issue that caused users' For You feeds to be overwhelmed with dozens of Musk tweets. Again, he bought the company. It's his company. He can do with it whatever the hell he wants to do. You don't have to like it. You don't have to pay for it. You know, maybe when Twitter becomes a ghost town and it's just a bunch of blue checks that aren't screaming at each other, maybe I'll go back more often. I don't know. Platformer later reported that Twitter employees had changed its algorithm to favor Musk after the CEO was mad that his Super Bowl tweet didn't receive as much engagement as Biden's. Musk reportedly fired an engineer who suggested the lack of engagement was due to declining interest in his tweets. Yeah, you don't tell the boss that he's boring, right? You know, anyway, I'll bring this up here real quick. Aaron Sparrow put this up. Actually, Dan Slott does not have me blocked, and I hope talking about Dan Slott will not prompt Dan Slott to remember to block me. But I think he had a blockchain set up, and I think that the API might have changed, because I know some apps that I had I'd been using with Twitter no longer work under Elon Musk. So I don't know. So this is Dan Slott, Spider-Man writer at Elon Musk. He thinks he's as important as William Shatner, I guess. I was verified during a time when I had multiple people pretending to be me online who were sending fake tweets to colleagues, customers, and my employer. I have 160,000 followers, provide free content, and bring traffic here. I will no longer do that without verification. Well, Dan, this is actually the first one of your tweets I've seen in about 4 years. So I guess I wasn't really missing much. Here's the truth, though, and this isn't anything against anybody that's on Twitter to promote themselves or to promote their comics. We don't get a lot of interaction from Twitter other than crazy people stalking us. That is pretty much it. Like, I think there are certain kinds of people that use Twitter, and I don't think it's everyday people. I don't think it's everyday normies. I don't think it's customers who are going to walk into a store and buy your product. I think most people are blissfully unaware that Twitter even is a thing. It only means something to people that are perpetually online. And I admit, I'm perpetually online. This is what I do, right? I'm on YouTube and blogging and all this other crap. But I think there's a huge disconnect. Twitter is not a service for, it's not like Facebook. It's not like where normies are using it. Twitter is definitely for certain kinds of people online. Again, people who are avid online users, who work in tech, who work in entertainment, who are, you know, digital journalists, politicians, you know, and it really is not a platform for normies. What I was hoping would happen is that Elon Musk would turn it into a platform for normies. But, you know, with an $8 cover charge, I don't know if he's going to be able to do that. I'm going to be honest. I think there are going to be fewer people using Twitter, but he's actually going to make more money in the long run because the people that stay actually want to be there and they're actually willing to pay the $8 to be there. That is my personal opinion of what is potentially going to happen. So I don't know, but there it is, guys. Twitter is absolutely positively pay to play. This is a new reality. I think the internet in general is going to be pay to play going forward. I think we're going to go back to, you know, kind of like individual websites and forums where they were constantly, you know, rattling the tin cup. Hey, you know, please support us, you know, subscribe to our newsletter, pay to subscribe to the newsletter, you know, pre-Patreon. And that is what we're probably going to have to go back to because the ads are definitely drying up. I'm going to wrap this up. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We'll talk later. Help support the channel. Go to thereef.support and get early access to podcasts, videos, and other content. That's thereef.support.